Hello everyone, welcome back to Math Stimulus. Here in this module, you are going to learn few important questions based on system of linear equations. Let us consider first question. Given two matrices A and B, where A is this 3x3 matrix and B is this 3x3 matrix. Question says find AB and use this result to solve the system of equations x minus 2y plus 3z is equal to 6, x plus 4y plus z is equal to 12, x minus 3y plus 2z is equal to 1. Children, question says A and B are two matrices, find AB. First, we need to find AB and then use this result to solve system of equation. Then use this result to solve system of these equations. So first, given A and B is there, multiply AB. This is your product matrix. You can see this is a matrix. You can take out minus 8. When you will take out minus 8, you will be left with minus 8 into 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. What is it? Minus 8 into identity matrix. So what you will get? Product of two matrices, AB is equal to minus 8 into I. So this is your product. So first part we have done, find AB. So AB is minus 8 into identity matrix. Now we are asked to use this result to solve this system of equation. Okay. Whenever we solve system of equation, we write system of equation in the form of AX is equal to B. What is A? A is coefficient matrix. Check. What are the coefficients here? 1, minus 2. 3. We can see 1 minus 2, 3. 1, 4, 1. 1, 4, 1. 1 minus 3, 2. 1 minus 3, 2. What we can see? The coefficient matrix of these three linear equations is the same as this matrix A. So now moving ahead, you can write, given system of equation in the form of AX is equal to B. This is your A. And you have seen this is the same matrix which is A given already. Now, we need to find solution of those equations. So whenever we solve matrix equation, we first calculate determinant of A. Determinant of A, if it is not equal to 0, then we say system of equation is consistent and it has unique solution. So what is the determinant of A here? It is minus 8, which is not equal to 0. Hence, system of equation is consistent and independent and it has unique solution. And how you will find unique solution? By X is equal to A inverse D. A inverse D. Now children, listen. In the previous module, you have learned how to find A inverse. You need to find A inverse by the formula 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. Here, how we are going to use the product to find the solution? This is important part. You know from the equation 1, product of two matrices AB is equal to minus 8i, identity matrix. Now, we use this to find A inverse. What we need here to find the solution, we need A inverse into D. D we are already having. D matrix we are having already. We need to find A inverse. And we will find this A inverse using this. How? Pre-multiplying both sides with this equation by the A inverse. So, you will get A inverse AB is equal to minus 8 A inverse I. A inverse A is equal to identity matrix. IB is equal to minus 8 A inverse and A inverse answers, you will get B is equal to IN B into is equal to B minus 8A inverse. So A inverse is simply 1 upon minus 8 into B. This is what? Minus 8. This is K. Children, यहाँ से आपको एक important result भी मिल रहा है. What is that? देखो, if product of two matrices is identity matrix, A B is equal to identity matrix, then what we say? B is equal to A inverse or A inverse is equal to B. What is difference here? Here is the difference, AB is equal to KI. What is K? K is equal to minus 8. So what is A inverse now? A inverse is 1 upon K, where K is minus 8 in our present case. So 1 upon K, B. If I need to find B inverse, what would be B inverse? B inverse would be 1 upon minus 8 into A. This is very very important point. So now we are able to find A inverse by just multiplying B matrix with 1 upon minus 8 and we will get A inverse. This is the use of this product. How we are going to use this product to find A inverse? I am sure you are very much clear. Later on you need not to solve these three steps again and again. I have explained you here just to make you clear about the concept. Every time if you are getting this type of the matrix, product matrix like K into I, K means K can be any real value, then you just simply write A inverse is equal to 1 upon K into B. Now moving ahead. So A inverse is minus 1 upon 8B. Put the value of B matrix, you get minus 1 upon 8B. Now X is equal to A inverse D. So put the value of A inverse, get multiplied A inverse into D and you have got the value 1, 2, 3. So X, Y, Z is equal to by equality of two matrices. X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 2. Here it is misprint beta. This must be Y is equal to 2 and Z is equal to 3. So answer is 1, 2, 3. This question was very, very important from CBSE point of view. Now we are on another hot question. This question already has come in Delhi 2017. What this question says? Use product of these two matrices to solve the system of equations. And system of equation is, this is the system of equation. Okay. Use product. Very much similar to the previous one, but what is the difference? We'll check. So first of all, find product. We'll find product. First, let us consider A be the pre-multiplier matrix and B be the post-multiplier matrix. So we have AB, product matrix. We have done the product and get identity matrix, where A is pre-multiplier and B be the post-multiplier matrix. So what we have got product? We have got AB as identity matrix. Now, given equation of set is X plus 3Z is equal to 9. Children, see, X plus Y is not here. So what is the coefficient of Y? That is 0. What are the coefficients here? 1, 0, 3. What are coefficients here? Minus 1, 2, minus 2. 2, minus 3, 4. So what is the coefficient matrix? 1, 0, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 2, minus 3, 4. So we can write this system of equation as AX is equal to B. Now we have converted this system of equation in the matrix form. But see carefully. In the previous slide, you can see what was A. In the previous slide, matrix A was, this was the matrix A. 1, minus 1, 2. 0, 2, minus 3. Focus on this first row. 1, minus 1, 2. Now, in this, in the, children, see, this is 1, minus 1, 2 and this is the given system of equation. Here it is 1, minus 1, 2. It is row and in the coefficient matrix of the system of linear equation, it is column. 1 minus 1 to row, 1 minus 1 to column. 0 to minus 3, 0 to minus 3. Second row, second column. Third row, third column is 3, 2, minus 3. So, 3 minus 2, 4. 3 minus 2, 4. This is third row, third column. So, what I mean to say, what is A matrix here? In this system of equation, your coefficient matrix is transpose of matrix A. That is transpose. So, what the difference we are going to have? We have converted this way. This is coefficient matrix A transpose. We are getting A transpose. A transpose X is equal to, this is matrix D. We have given this name D because A and B already we have considered. B already we have considered. So, we have considered this matrix as D. Now, I need to find this X. Children, what we do to find the X, Y, Z? We find determinant of this coefficient matrix. If determinant is not equal to 0, then we find X is equal to A inverse D. Now, in present case, we'll check first what is the determinant of this matrix. If it is not equal to 0, to X hum kaise nikalenge? Yahan se X would be this matrix, A transpose matrix. A transpose matrix ka inverse. Inverse of A transposed matrix means this matrix is matrix ka inverse. So X is equal to inverse of this matrix into D. See, first of all, we are going to find the determinant of the coefficient matrix. Coefficient matrix is a transposed of A. So we have find determinant, it is 1 not equal to 0. What does it mean? It is consistent and has unique solution. So what is X? X is inverse of A transpose into D matrix. Okay. Now, how to use the product? Product, we have to solve this equation using the product. What was product we have got from equation 1? We have got AB is equal to I. Product of two matrices is identity matrix. This implies is B matrix is equal to inverse of A. B matrix is equal to inverse of A. Now children, see. This is inverse of A transpose into D. We also can write it as A inverse ka transpose. You have remembered we have done this property while we were doing transpose. Means A inverse of A transpose is equal to transpose of A inverse. We are going to use this result here. Why we are going to use this result here? Because A inverse is equal to B matrix. A inverse is equal to B matrix. But what we required inverse of transpose matrix. So if we are taking transpose at this step, what we are going to get? B transpose is equal to transpose of A inverse. So B transpose is equal to transpose of A inverse. That means transpose of A inverse is equal to inverse of A transpose. These both terms are equal and this is equal to B of T. B of T means matrix B ka transpose and matrix B is already with us. So what we need to do just to find this term or this term. What is this inverse of A transpose? Just do the transpose of matrix B. So we need to calculate this. B transpose. This is the value we'll calculate transpose of B matrix and put it here and multiply it with D matrix and we'll get X. So, A inverse transpose is B transpose. Matrix B ka transpose kiya humne. B matrix is this. Minus 201. Isko humne dekho column wise likha. This is second row, second column, third row, third column. This is your matrix. A inverse transpose. Put the value here. A inverse transpose is B transpose only. This matrix. Put this matrix. This matrix here, D multiply, get the answer by the equality of two matrices. You have got the answer 0, 5, 3. So this is the answer. So here, this was the word problem. Previous slide, where we have used this result. This is very, very important result. This question has already come in Delhi 2017. So whenever in system of equation you are getting transposed matrix, there we need to use this result, and these three steps are very, very important. I hope you are very much clear. Try to solve one or two questions from Gupta Bansal or RD similar type so that you can practice this kind of the question. Here it is the last question of chapter 4 miscellaneous, question 16. Solve the system of following equation. Equation is 2 upon x plus 3 upon y plus 10 upon z is equal to 4. Here variable x is in rational form, and you need to solve this system of equation. Children, what is hint here? I am just giving you hint. You will solve it by your own. Put 1 upon x is equal to u, 1 upon y is equal to v, 1 upon z is equal to w. So what this equation reduced to? 2u plus 3v plus 10w is equal to 4. So now this has reduced to your very much familiar term, familiar equation. Likewise, convert this equation and this equation and solve for u, v, w. And later on, from you will get value of u, v, w. From here, you will get the value of x. X is equal to 1 upon u, y is equal to 1 upon v, and z is equal to 1 upon w. The final answer aapka xyz mein hi aayega because equations are given in xyz only. Don't leave your answer in terms of u, v, w, because u, v, w are the variables you have considered for your convenience. So never leave your answer in terms of u, v, w. Final answer would be 1 upon u, 1 upon v, and 1 upon w in terms of xyz only. I hope these questions are very much clear to you. Stay tuned in for further videos. Have fun. Enjoy learning. Goodbye.